Hello everyone, I hope you're all having a fabulous Monday. Today I'm coming at you with our weekly Minx Monday Q&A. Before we get started, let me share the bag that I'm currently rocking, and that is the Louis Vuitton Alma Bibi in the Damia Ben canvas. Alright, so grab your coffee, grab your tea, let's start your workout, let's go to work, whatever it is that you do, come join me. We have some awesome topics to cover today. Starting with the first question from LuxLoverVB81. Should items we buy pre-owned from Fashion File or Yogi's Closet be authenticated again, or is their guarantee enough? This is a fantastic question, and I'm not sure if I've answered it before. If I have, my apologies. But I am a big fan of the pre-loved market, and it doesn't necessarily have to apply to these two companies. I love everything that's out there, especially the pricing, and you can find some great, great deals. But for me, getting an item authenticated from an outside source, so double authenticated, it makes sense, especially because there's so many super fakes out there. And I feel that even though a lot of these companies have dedicated professionals that look at every single nook and cranny, there's always a possibility that one of those super fakes will go through undetected. You know, it'll kind of slip past. Mistakes happen. So getting that item double authenticated gives you that peace of mind. And what I particularly love about Fashion File and Yogi's Closet is that they also encourage people to get the item authenticated if they wanted to. You know, it's not like they're sitting there saying, no, it's authentic and that's all you need is our word and our guarantee. No, they sit there and they're like, yeah, absolutely. Take whatever pictures you need and get them authenticated if it makes you feel better. So I think that that really speaks volumes of the companies. And when you think about the prices that you'd be paying for the pre-loved goods compared to getting something authenticated, an authentication can be up to $50. It really depends on the company that you end up going through versus $1,200, $3,000, $5,000, $10,000 on a handbag. There's no comparison, you know what I mean? And especially if you get any item from any company when it comes to pre-loved goods and it makes you feel uneasy, if your gut instinct says something's not right about it, by all means, get it authenticated, even if it is a reputable source, because you never know. So for me, it always, you know, like I said, it makes sense to me and I've always done it. I had a really bad experience. I think it was like 5 or 6 years ago. That really pushed me to do it, because I think that the peace of mind, there's really no price that you can put on that. You know what I mean? It's like you can breathe, you can relax, and it's just like, okay, you know, it's not like you're walking around unbeknownst to you with a super fake when you've put that money towards getting an authentic handbag. You know what I mean? So I say yes, go for it. It makes me feel 1,000 times better, but it's all personal preference. But hopefully that was able to help. All right, next one from it's a mandatory. Very clever. I like the way you have your name here. I just bought a Speedy Bandolier 25 pre-owned from Fashion File. The listing has it just missing the key and lock. Is there any way I can get a replacement? How would Louis Vuitton handle it? Or could any Speedy be key open it? First and foremost, congratulations on your Speedy 25 Bandolier. That is awesome. Love that bag. Okay, and it says that, is there any way that I can get a replacement? How would Louis Vuitton handle it? You can get a replacement. I do have a little lock and key here. Now, you can go into the boutique, and some sales associates will end up charging you for it. I think it's $20 or $25 to get a replacement lock and key, and they have them readily available. But most sales associates will just say, yeah, go ahead, here it is, and not charge you for it. Funny thing is that this particular lock belongs to my Mon Mono, and the key, they're all numbered. So let me show you guys really quickly. The lock has a little number on there, and the key has the coordinating or the corresponding number to the lock. Now, they all have certain grooves, but the lock on my Mon Mono, or the key on my Mon Mono, opens up the same lock on my Speedy 20, or my Speedy my Speedy 30 Damia's Door, and on my Speedy Bandolier. But I tried it out right now with the Alma Bibi, and I can't get it in there to save my life. It has a little bit of a different groove. So it seems that, I think it's a cute idea that they have everything with numbers, but I think because of the same style, they might be able to open up the same ones. That is just my assumption, but I would go into the boutique and let them know and say, hey, you know, can I get a replacement? And you should have no problems whatsoever. They won't ask you, where did you buy the item? Did you buy it here or anything like that? You could just say, yeah, I'm looking for a replacement for my lock and key, and you shouldn't have any issues whatsoever. But again, congratulations on your bag and enjoy that bag. Next question from Ariana Kristen. Hopefully I said that correctly. All of a sudden, I am seeing Valentino and Valentino Garavani all over the place. I know it's from the same fashion house, but what is the difference? Is one more expensive or luxurious than the other? This is a wonderful question, and I will make sure and put the correct enunciation for all of my Italians out there when I say Valentino Garavani. All right, so when it comes to Valentino and Valentino Garavani, they are two completely different fashion houses. Valentino is Mario Valentino, and a lot of his items, you can find them for the handbags, you can find them at Nordstrom Rack, Saks Off the Fifth, Neiman Marcus Last Call, and they can be anywhere up to $1,000. And a lot of the designs for the handbags are very similar to Gucci, Chanel. They take inspiration from those other fashion houses and they incorporate it into their own designs. So when it comes to Valentino Garavani, they're the ones that are, you know, in charge of the rock studs, the brand that I have completely fallen head over heels for. And their handbags are anywhere from starting $1,000 up to $4,000, $5,000. It depends the type of details that you're looking at. So they are two completely different fashion houses. Now, when it comes to Valentino Garavani, they do have a lower end line, which is Red Valentino. They have a lot of clothing. They do have some handbags, and the handbags I think can be up to $1,000. I think I've seen that are like up to $1,500 as well, but it all depends. Valentino Garavani does have two different lines, but the other one, the regular Valentino that you end up seeing, it is Mario Valentino, so completely different. I know it can be a little confusing because when I first found out a few years ago, I remember thinking, oh, it's the same fashion house. I thought the exact same thing, and then it wasn't. I was just like, wait, what? No way. So yeah, two totally different ones. So hopefully that was able to help. All right. Next question from Melanie Martinez. Minnie, what do you think about upgrading wedding rings? Have you or your hubby thought about upgrading? Fabulous question. And when it comes to upgrading wedding rings, I love the fact that a lot of people end up doing it for their, milestone anniversaries, whether it's their 10, 15, or whether it's their 10, 20, 25, 50. I think it's really beautiful, but it's not for me, and I think that's the main reason why we ended up going with our right hand rings for our 10-year wedding anniversary. I got the Cartier Love Ring, and Robert got the Louis Vuitton Signet Ring, because I cannot imagine parting with my wedding set. There is no way. I wouldn't want to change a thing about it, and it really needs to be cleaned. But what I love about this wedding set is that Robert picked it out himself. We didn't pick it out together. We didn't go in and say, okay, this is the ring that I want for our wedding or anything like that. He went on his own and he picked it out. And the fact that he picked it out and this is what he liked, I will never, ever, ever part with it. There is no way. Unfortunately, it is very big on my hand because of my weight loss. So I do have to get it resized, but I wouldn't change a single thing about it. There is no way. So while I love the idea about upgrading rings, it is not for me, because I even told him, I said, you're gonna have to pry this off of my dead cold finger, because I am madly in love with this wedding set and the meaning behind it. So no, not for me. But great question. All right, next one from Fiona Duong. Hopefully I said that correctly. I just got my first Chanel wallet on chain. Congratulations. Silver hardware, caviar leather, black. Awesome. Can you please do an updated on how to stop the zipper on the top to stop it from putting a dent in the leather? Fantastic question. So here is my wallet on chain. And the best way to help that this cute little zipper here is not as deadly to the leather here is by putting a felt on it whenever you go to store it. Now, it won't completely get rid of the dent. It won't end up, it'll cause it to be a lot a lot less noticeable. You know what I mean? And I mean, you'll still be able to see it there. You can see that it makes quite an indentation. So if you didn't have the felt, you'll be able to notice it a lot more. So if you have a felt on here, it could be any felt. It doesn't necessarily have to be from Chanel. But if you put it in here, it really stops it from digging in. Another thing that I would also recommend is when you go to store this, I don't close mine. I leave mine open. So that way I'm not putting any more pressure on the zipper for the leather, you know what I mean? So I leave it open, it stands on its own, and I don't have to worry that it's gonna put too much of a dent in there. And I really think that it's helped all these years that I've had it just kind of sitting opened up. So it ends up working out for me, and that's what I would recommend. But if any of you guys out there have any suggestions, let us know in the comment section down below, because I love that there's so much information in the comment section. I absolutely love it. I love how everyone shares their experiences, and they share little details that ends up, you know, working for them. So keep them coming. But that is what I end up doing, and hopefully that ends up helping you out as well. I don't know why I'm getting so tongue-tied. Why is that? I think it's because I had a little too much caffeine this morning. It's not like I need caffeine either, because the alarm goes off and I'm just like, wait, what? I'm awake. Anywho, let's get back to this. All right, next one from Evie Pereira, hopefully I said that correctly. I was wondering your thoughts on the Palm Springs mini backpack, since I see you rocking a teeny bag there yourself. I just ordered one and currently stocking the mailman, but I am super nervous about this purchase. It will be my most expensive and smallest bag to date, but I think it will hold a lot of my essential small leather goods. I haven't heard of too many wear woos, but still wanted some thoughts. All right, so wonderful, wonderful question. I will make sure and put a link to the Louis Vuitton website so you guys can check out the Palm Springs mini backpack if you want further eye candy, because I do not have one in my collection. All right, so when it comes to the Palm Springs mini backpack, I have had other backpacks from Louis Vuitton, and I always love them. I'm always attracted to backpacks, but they don't end up working out for me, because I feel like a vulture is what I feel like, because I automatically put my shoulders up, and I feel really uncomfortable when I go to put it on. And because of my curviness, when I go to put it completely on my back, I think it looks weird on me. But everyone who owns this backpack loves this backpack, because as what you said, you end up fitting so many of your small leather goods in there. Even though it's small, and you know, I've said this with other handbags, looks can be very, very deceiving. They end up putting everything in their water bottles, and they end up using them mostly for travel because of the treated leather. You don't have to worry about water stains. You don't have to worry about anything like that. So I really do love this backpack. So much so that even with the two that I've had in my collection, and I have sold off for the reasons that I told you, that I feel like I look like Heckle and Jekyll. I am totally dating myself here, but if you guys know who Heckle and Jekyll are, you'll know. That's who I feel like when I'm wearing the backpack. Anyways, I am super intrigued about this backpack, so much so that I was talking to my sales associate and I said, you know, I really like this bag. I keep thinking about it. I keep looking at it. Everyone raves about it. There's something that just attracts me to it. So I told her, I said, can you put me on the list for one if you get one? I'd really want to check it out. No kidding. She got one, or no joke, she got one like a week later, and she's all, Minnie, we got the backpack in. I'm really excited, so you can come check it out. And for some reason or another, I couldn't get to the boutique that same day, and I couldn't get to the boutique until the weekend. And I said, is it possible for you to hold it? They really frown upon holds, because, you know, there's other people that are looking for items. But she said, yeah, no problem. I'll go ahead and hold it for you. So I was supposed to go there on a Sunday, and it was on, she called me on Saturday, and she said, hey, about the backpack, she said, I still have it on hold for you. I have someone that's asking about it. Do you want to just go ahead and buy it so it's out of the system? And then if you don't like it, you can go ahead and return it. And it's funny that she called when she did, because I was going to tell her later that day that I wasn't going to be able to make it on the weekend. And I said, you know what? I don't want to cause anything because of my indecisiveness. You know, I'm still unsure about this bag. And if someone's asking about it and they really like it, I would much rather it go to them. And, you know, I'll get it sometime in the future if it's meant to be. So she released it, and the person ended up getting it, and they were super, super stoked. So I didn't get it. Then when we went to Hawaii, I had asked, and at the Hilton, they had a backpack. And I was going to go down later that evening, and I said, and I even told the sales associate, I said, I'll be right back. I'm going to come check it out. Something happened to where I forgot, and I went the following morning, and they're like, oh, we had to sell it. We had someone that asked about it. That is twice that I have asked about this bag. It has been almost in my hand, and it slips out. I'm taking this as a sign that bag does not belong to me. You know what I mean? It's not going to happen. So I think that this bag is fantastic. Congratulations on this backpack. I absolutely love it. I love what it offers. I love that you can end up adjusting the straps. And, I think you're going to have so much fun with it. So congratulations on it. And I'm sorry I went on that tangent, but I just had to share that story with you guys. You know me, I'm always sharing. All right, next one from Loa Christensen. Hopefully I said that correctly. Let's talk Chanel fine jewelry. If you were to choose a piece, what would it be? Awesome question. Hands down, it would be the Coco Crush ring. It was a line that was recently released. I think it might have been a year now. Maybe it's a little bit less. I'm not too sure. But the Coco Crush, I would get the ring. They have earrings and they have a bracelet, but it is just the quilted, it has the quilted design on this really, on this very wide band. And I'm all about wide band rings. That's something that I really like. And I like the simplest one. And I believe they retail for $2,250 for the simple one, and they're 18 karat gold. And they can go up to like $4,000, $4,500 when you start to incorporate diamonds into it. But I love it. I think it is gorgeous. Gorgeous. When I went into the boutique, I did try it on. But I kept thinking, you know how many handbags I can get with? I can get with this. So I passed on it, but that is hands down what I would end up getting for sure. Next question from Kimberly Wilson. If resale value was not a consideration, what are your thoughts on leaving your bags out of the dust bag in a closet without direct sunlight? I really struggle with wanting them to stay like new and taking care of them, but also wanting to display them because they are beautiful. We spend so much of our hard-earned money on them that it seems wrong to keep them hidden away from view. However, I do not want to do anything that could damage the bags or SLGs. I am just torn as to the best answer. Fantastic question. So if resale value wasn't in the mix, and if I didn't have a room that had so much sunlight gracing my handbags, would I end up doing it? I don't think so. I don't think so, which makes no sense because it's the sunlight that I freak out about the most. But I don't think I would. I'm also the type of person that when I had my Barbies, I would always put them back into their little spaces. You know what I mean? I could have left them out and about like everyone else, but no, everything had to have a place. So I always say that I think I have some form of OCD when it comes to things like that. But you know, I know a lot of people that leave their handbags in closets. They have like these massive closets with these beautiful shelves, and they display their handbags out that way. And it ends up working out perfectly because they don't have any sunlight coming through, or they don't have a space that has so much moisture in the air. Like if you live somewhere where it's humid or anything like that. So it works out for a lot of people, and you're able to see the handbags just look oh so beautiful. But again, I think for me and my own paranoia, I won't do it. I don't think I could. And I'm just being 100% honest with you, because as much as I would want to, I think I would compulsively still put them in their dust bags. I don't even know who I am, you know? So I wouldn't, but like I said, a lot of people have had so much success with leaving them out, and it doesn't cause any damage to their handbags or anything whatsoever. You know, just to make sure that your handbags are stuffed so that way they keep their shape, and if you do live somewhere where that is humid, make sure that you just have like silica packets or something to where you won't have moisture, you know, kind of going into your handbags. So hopefully that was able to help. All right, last question from Courtney R. I have a question for your next Mix Monday. It's a tough one for me to ask, as I know I may receive judgment from some viewers, but I am struggling with this and I need some advice. So I will be brave and ask it. Okay, here goes. On that same note, before I get into it, I want you guys to know that when it comes to my channel, if I see any type of judgment or anything like that, I will always take the comment off if someone's being rude to someone else, because I want my channel, I want my comment section to be incredibly friendly, and that's what I love about it. That's how it's pretty much been this whole time. Don't ever feel that anyone's going to judge you or anything like that. This is 100% a judge-free zone, and that is how I'm going to, that's how I'm going to keep it, and I will do my hardest and my best to ensure that it stays that way. So I applaud you for asking the question that you're about to ask. I have 6 Louis Vuitton purses plus a handful of Louis Vuitton accessories. My amazing husband was able to purchase and gift these to me a couple few years ago. But since then, times have changed and we are in a season of difficulty right now in terms of finances. The kind of difficulty where we cannot even go out to eat or go to an event if it costs, let alone shop anymore. Because of this, we have asked here and there for financial assistance from our community, like our church, family, etc. My question is, would you stop carrying around the flashy Louis Vuitton pretties that bring my heart so much happiness during this difficult season because of the possible judgment that we may receive? Or would you not even give it a second thought and still continue to carry what makes your heart sing because they were gifts and made to be used / enjoyed? This is probably the hardest question that I have ever had when it comes to Minx Monday, only because I see both sides. So I see, I can definitely understand where you're coming from. One part of me says that I'm the type of person that says, no matter what, do what makes your heart sing. If that's what you love, then go for it. You know, I don't really pay attention to what other people say, other negative things that people might say. You know, like I always take everything with a grain of salt. I'm just kind of like, yeah, it is, you know, you think what you think and I'm going to do me type of thing. But in this particular instance, unfortunately, we live in a society where that judgment is going to come no matter what. And, you know, well, a lot of us here understand the love for luxury goods and we understand, handbags and the craziness that goes behind it. There are a lot of people that don't get it. There's a lot of people that disagree with the amount of money that we spend on these handbags and why we like them so much. And we get judgment on that already. So with this, I feel that, you know, I'm so torn because part of me wants to say, do it no matter what. And the other part of me says that I think that a lot of people will judge it and they'll end up saying, well, if you're carrying a Louis Vuitton handbag, why are you asking for money? Not knowing the story behind how you acquired the items. They'll just jump right into, well, you know, what about this? What about your handbag? What about that? So I think that if it were me, I would probably, as much joy as they bring me, I think that I would end up not carrying them while this is going through, while the difficulty is there. I would end up, I would not, you know, end up carrying my handbags as much as I love them, because I know that people aren't going to understand. And it's really bad because I know all of us here get it. We understand, but no one, there's not a lot of people out there that have an open mind and can see beyond what it is. You know, just like there's some people that end up looking at others that are, you know, that use food stamps and they look at them in a different way. They start the judgment. It's just there. And it's really sad that people can't look beyond that. But I feel that you'll end up getting the judgment. So I would personally refrain from doing it. I know you and your family are going through a difficult time right now, and my heart goes out to you. And I really wish that you weren't going through this. But I know that you guys will prevail. I know that everything will be okay and everything will go back to normal. It's just a small bump in the road. But I really wish that I could give you better advice. I feel like I'm absolutely failing when it comes to this question because I am so torn. When I start to lean one way, then I start looking at it in a different way. You know, the my heart of hearts says rock it no matter what because it brings you joy, especially during such a difficult time. That by using the handbags, it kind of takes you out of the out of the funk, out of the gloominess that's going on. And then the other part of me says that, you know, unfortunately, people don't get it. People don't understand our love for handbags. And, you know, to just put them aside for now, it will be a short time before everything goes back to normal. So my apologies for not being able to give you, you know, advice, because I am so like conflicted as to what would be the best way to go about it. But like I said, in my own opinion, if it was me, I definitely wouldn't end up using the bag. And I know that usually goes against everything that I say when it comes to making your heart sing, but this is a different situation. So if you guys have any advice for Courtney, let us know in the comment section down below. And remember, there's never any judgment here on my channel. Not at all. I will see it and I'll delete it. I'll get rid of it, because at the end of the day, it's my channel and I don't want to see that. I am all about positivity. You know what I mean? So I am sending you a huge, huge hug and a huge kiss your way, and much, much love to you, Courtney. But thank you for the wonderful question, and hopefully I was able to help a little bit. If I'm not able to help, hopefully someone in the comment section will. All right, you guys, so that does it for our Minx Monday Q&A. I really enjoyed this week's Q&A. I hope I was able to give you guys a little bit of insight on some of your questions. I know that I went on a few different tangents. We all know how I am, but I still had a blast doing it. Now, for this week's lineup, I really don't know what's in the cards. It's kind of all over the place. I'm kind of playing it day by day. I do have some things in line that I want to do, but I also want to have, I want to do different videos as well. So who knows what that's going to be for this week. But if you guys enjoyed it, make sure and give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already and you would like to, please subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the red button down below and hitting that bell so you're notified when I upload videos, which is anywhere from 2 to 3 times a week. And I will see you all later this week. And as always, make it a fabulous day or not. The choice is yours. Have a great day, you guys.